Hey, what's going on, guys? I have forgotten to include this in the actual commentary itself, but the gameplay you're seeing here is me rolling around with a couple of other friends on the server that I usually play on, and we're basically doing a job because we were bored one night and wanted to take the Flying Fortress out for a spin, and we decided, hey, you might as well go around trying to do a job or two. So this is what you're seeing here, and hopefully you enjoy what you see, and yeah, let's talk about the quests. Hey there, what's going on, guys? My name is Asian Psycho, and right now you guys are going to be watching a tutorial video of DayZ Origins as of 1.7.8 patch, sorry. And in this tutorial video, we're going to be learning on how the quests work in DayZ Origins 1.7.8.5 patch. I think that's the right patch number, right? So, if you guys don't know, as of the last patch, which was 7.8.5, I don't wonder how many times I'm going to say that, you can actually get quests while you are in-game. It should be active in every single server. If it's not, then there's probably something wrong with that server. And if you're part of that server, you might want to see that checked out. But anyways, you can now do little side quests that kind of arguably do spice up the gameplay experience in DayZ Origins, the Origins mod as a whole, because there's just a lot more to do, and especially for non-PvP servers or PvE only servers, it really does help, you know, give you a lot more to do because it actually gives you a lot more people to shoot other than the guys over at Sector B and Ivan's lab. So that being said, we're going to be going in and picking apart just the general details of the quests as a whole, and later on I will continue this series and show you exactly how you guys can go about doing every single job specifically. But for right now, this video is only concerned with just the general tidbits, like, you know, the facts that everyone should know when, you know, trying to do a quest as a whole. So that being said, let's go ahead and talk about them. So Very general, very basic stuff right off the bat. In order to see the quests, you must have a new item called the PDA Electronica. They put this in as part of the 7.8.5 patch, you know, obviously alongside with the quests, because the PDA Electronica is the tool that you must have in order to see what kinds of quests that are coming up. Where you can find them is at helicopter crashes mainly, and also you can find them very easily at Ivan's lab. I may do a separate tutorial video on how to clear Ivan's lab and what it looks like later on, but right now, just know that you can find PDA Electronica tablets, whatever they're called, over in helicopter crashes, which have also been changed, by the way. They no longer spawn exclusively on coastlines, but they can now spawn literally anywhere, like in the middle of a field, on top of a mountain somewhere. They can literally spawn anywhere as opposed to only on the coastline. Doesn't mean they can't spawn on coastlines, but just know that the majority of them will be spawning much further inland, as, you know, we might be, as contrary as what we have been, you know, used to in the past patches. So, once again, you can find PDA Electronicas in those helicopter crashes or Ivan's lab. Last time I did go to Ivan's lab, it did give me two PDAs, so I'm not really too sure if the loot spawns are the same every time you clear Ivan's lab, or if they, you know, recycle or change somehow. But granted, you can find a couple PDAs there. Now, assuming you do have a PDA, what you need to do is you need to equip it. Obviously, it is a tool, which not a lot of people know, so just put it into your tool belt, and once it's on your tool belt, you can now press 7. Every time you log into a server after it's freshly restarted, there will be a quest, and the way you know that you have a new quest, or if there's any sort of update to the quest, or any kind of quest at all, is if you look above your PvP meter, which is the little Glock looking thing where on the lower right hand corner of your screen, where it has your food, your drink, your blood, and the little gun that means the PvP meter. Right above the PvP meter, there should be a flashing yellow triangle that looks like it has like a scroll on it, and it'll be flashing. And if it's flashing, that means that either there's a new quest or there is an update to a previous quest that's already been up there, and it means that someone's, you know, either doing it or they activated it or whatever. So if you see that, go ahead and immediately press 7, because it'll keep flashing until you actually press 7, you know, check your PDA. Once you press 7, like a big kind of green screen will come up. It's kind of like a map, but it doesn't take up your entire screen. It just enlarges the PDA so you guys can actually read it. And on there, you should be able to see a list of jobs or quests that are currently available. Again, at the start of a restart or at the start of a server restart, there should only be one quest available, and over time there will be more quests that will fill in. We'll get to that later, but for now, just know that you can access the PDA and look at what it says with the 7 key. Mind you, it's not the 7 key on the numpad, but it's the 7 key on just the top row of numbers above your QWERTY, you know, letters. Now, with that being said, that's a very basic, you know, quest information. Now let's go into the more detail of these, you know, quests and what they really are and, you know, stuff like that. So, quests in general, I do believe, come up every roughly half hour. Most server restarts most servers operate on a 4-hour server restart basis, or a 4-hour day-night cycle, where maybe 2.5 hours is day, and then the like 1.5 hours towards the end is nighttime. Every half hour, I believe, or somewhere around that, you will get another quest. Might be every hour or so, it depends. On the server that I play on, it works on an 8-hour server basis, so we do get quite a lot of quests by the time another server restart rolls around, so that's that. But just keep in mind, there is a quest roughly every half hour or hour. Again, I'm not really too sure, but it's around there. As for the quests themselves, the quests are mostly the same. You'll see that as you pay attention to the quest lists over, you know, a week or two, you'll start noticing that the quests oftentimes repeat themselves. In fact, they repeat themselves a lot. So there may be a few that, you know, maybe you haven't seen before because it hasn't spawned for that particular server restart. Maybe that might be the case, but for the most part, after maybe a week or so of looking at the PDA and, you know, seeing what kind of jobs come up, you should be able to recognize all of them within a short period of time. There are a lot of jobs, but it's not enough where you're like, oh, I've never seen that one before. Eventually, you will recognize every one of them and say, oh yeah, I know that one, oh, I've done that one before, so just keep that in mind. That being said, the spawns for the quests aren't always the same. For example, one of the missions, mission called Lone Ural, the first time I did that mission, there was an AI spawn inside the 3-story industrial in the city of Sebastopol. Now, I've never seen that ever again. Two other times I've actually done the Sebastopol job or the Lone Ural quest, so I can say with confidence that the quests in DayZ Origins have relatively random spawns. They're gonna spawn in the same areas, like relatively the same areas, but as for their exact positions, not gonna spawn in the same place every single time. They do kind of switch up spawns on you every once in every time you do the same job over and over, and that's something you just need to watch out for, because if you go in there expecting everything to be exactly the same, it might work for some jobs, but for others, not. That's not a safe attitude to have. Just always just keep in the back of your mind that, oh, hey, you know, the AI might spawn somewhere else as opposed to last time we did this job. So, again, always keep in mind that the spawns may not always be the same. The rewards, however, on the other hand, are a much different story. The rewards for each job, or each quest rather, remain the same every single time. So if there's a specific job that you have done before, and you've checked the rewards and you like what you see, then it's probably a good idea to do that job over and over if you want, you know, whatever comes out of that quest as a reward, because the quests will always give you the same exact rewards every single time, no matter how many people do it, if you do it by yourself, no matter how you do it, it's going to be the same. Just, you know, the quests are very, very, you know, I guess they're very flexible in that sense, where it'll just give the same reward every single time, no matter what you do. So, actually, that's not really called flexible, whatever. In any case, like I said, rewards are same every single time. The rewards, talking more a little bit about the rewards for these quests, the rewards vary on the difficulty of the kind of quest you're doing. This is just a general rule of thumb. There may be some jobs that are harder than others and don't give as good as rewards as you might hope. That's certainly the case with the Ekaterinburg job. I think that's called Salvation Business, where for the amount of work that you have to put into it, it's probably not a very good you know, reward set at the end of the day if you think about it. But again, that's, I'll talk about that later. Just remember that rewards do vary. They tend to scale up with the difficulty of a quest. Just keep that in mind. Some quests are harder than others, obviously, and you know, just something you just have to kind of figure out by yourself, or you can just watch my videos that might come later when I do tutorial videos on each of these single jobs and tell you what to do exactly and tell you what rewards they give you. Then you could just do that. Also, one more more things about the quests in general, not just the rewards. Depending on where your base is located, you might find yourself based just outside a potential quest location. On my server, for example, there's a couple guys that I know that have made a e-house nest base. Just, I think it's the southern end, like southern central end of Krasnodemensk airfield down at the southern island. Unfortunately for them, there's a job that spawns right on the airfield. And there was this one day where all three of them spawned in, or two of them rather, spawned in, and got shot immediately when they spawned in, and they just, you know, died literally in their own base, because there were a couple AI up the hill from their base up towards the southern end, the southern mountains of the airfield, and they were hiding behind a couple bushes and they just got sniped. So just be careful of that. You might be living right outside, or maybe inside for all I care, a potential quest. So just please be careful of that, and because these AI don't fuck around, they will kill you on spot. So yeah, just keep in mind that you may not be exactly safe where you live, and if you do feel like it's way too risky to have a base, or yeah, a base right outside, like in the area of a quest, that and you don't want to get caught in a crossfire, then it's probably a good idea to demolish your houses and go somewhere else. You know, it already sucks as it is dying in Origins. Don't really need to, you know, suffer the pain of getting sniped inside your own base. So, just letting you guys know. On top of which, there are quests that are in close proximity to one another. For example, the Lone Ural job and the Military Base job are very, very close to each other. Literally, they're not even 200, 300, 400 meters away from each other. So there have been instances where I've been flying around doing jobs. I've been doing one job, and all of a sudden the PDA says, "Oh, hey, guess what? There's a job like 200, not even 200 meters away from you. You activated that one too. Good luck." So just be aware of the fact that the quests might pull a fast one on you and give you two jobs back to back when you don't even want to. So just be careful of that. You might take a little bit extra fire. Just make sure that you're careful and that you're not in the wrong place at the wrong time when the PDA spawns in another job that's, like, you know, right behind your back or something. So just be careful of that. Most of these quests involve fighting against weaker hero and a bandit AI, but there are some quests that do spawn Sector B guards. Most quests usually spawn anywhere from like 3 to maybe 7, or maybe upwards to like 10, maybe, yeah, 10 or so, you know, hero or bandit AI. They're kind of like the ones that you see in Wasteland, if you guys ever played the Wasteland mod for Arma 2, but they're definitely, they might have the same amount of health, but they're definitely a lot smarter and a lot more lethal. Their aim is very, very good, as opposed to, you know, if the ones you play over in Wasteland or whatever. So just be careful. Just because the Bandit AI or the Hero and Bandit AI aren't as powerful as the Sector B guards doesn't really exactly mean that they can't just pick your head off from like 800 meters with an M24. So just keep that in mind. They're still very, very dangerous. It's just you can kill them easier, but they're no less dangerous in terms of, you know, how, you know, their aimbots or, you know, their pathing or whatever. More things about the AI themselves, especially the hero and the bandit AI. This may pertain to the Sector B guards as well that do spawn in certain quests, but the hero and bandit AI are programmed to have a tendency to wander around a lot. So if you do activate a job, if you don't see them at first, it's typically a good idea to sit in one place and be patient until you can actually see them. Most of the time, they will show themselves to you as opposed to you trying to run around to find them. Of course, this isn't always the case, but generally speaking, this is a good idea. It's much better to play it safe than to be reckless and rush out there and get shot in the face. You know, that's not what you want. Also, just from pure experience with and doing these jobs in conjunction with other in coordination with other friends and other people who are also interested in doing these jobs, it seems like the Hero and Bandit AI have an effective range of 800 meters if you are not in a vehicle. If you're in some sort of vehicle like a car or a helicopter, then they're it seems like their range is a lot further than that. Maybe I'd say up to like 1,000 meters or 1,200 meters, so to say. But typically, if you are on foot, I've never seen an AI get a kill further away from 800 meters. Most I've ever seen was like maybe around 720 something with and that was a guy who was in a ghillie suit, or it was an AI in a ghillie suit with an M24. However, that doesn't mean that if they're on a vehicle, they can't kill it further. I've seen on certain jobs they do spawn the DKSH machine gun and UAZMG car, whatever that's called, and I have seen that thing headshot one of my friends who was flying around the Flying Fortress at a distance like nearly 900 meters, and he was in the air too. So yeah, that's if they're in a vehicle, that's also a different story as well. And if you're in a vehicle, that's also a different story. But if both of you are on foot, then typically speaking, anywhere beyond 800 meters is generally a safe distance away. So I'd recommend that if you guys have the option to snipe them from more than 800 meters away, go ahead and do that, because at that distance, they might be able to take a few shots at you, but as long as you're behind cover, they shouldn't really be able to hit you. Let's see. I think that's enough about the AI themselves. The quests themselves will actually remain active until server restarts. Every time a server or a quest spawns in, it will stay there until it is finished. Or if you know, you can activate it. No one really has to, you know, do them. And the AI aren't gonna like patrol the map like the Sector B guards do from the patrolling AI helicopters. You know, the two Hueys that fly around. If they land, and that means that the guards typically hop out and they start roaming around their usual you know helicopter patrol route as if you know they were still in a helicopter. But for the quests, they don't do that. They will always stay in one place. They'll stay in the general area where their quests spawned, so you don't have to worry about them like roaming the map all the time. So you don't have to worry about that. Like I said, though, the quest will stay there until either someone completes them or until the server restarts. And by that point, the server restart will wipe all the quests, and it'll start replacing them with a new one, and then you know add more, so on and so forth, and keep doing that. It's an endless cycle. The quests will only begin, however, if someone actually activates it. Just because a quest spawned in doesn't mean it's actually started. For example, this is especially true of the Euro missions, where a lot of missions, or quite a few of the missions, actually involve you trying to locate a damaged Euro, and you need to find it first. And then once you actually find it, and if you see it and get it within a close enough distance, it'll actually blow up. And that means that'll be the initiation of the AI spawning in, you know, into their locations, and then you know you have to kill them and all that. Typically speaking, you don't have to worry about the AI spawning right away. It's only when someone actually goes near them and then updates the PDA for you, and that's when you know the Hero AI, the Band AI, whatever, will actually drop in, and then you know they'll start shooting people, whoever they see. So, there you go. If you're on a PvP server, just remember that the quests can be done by anyone. They don't have to have a PDA. If they're smart enough, they'll actually recognize that, hey, look, there's our AI over there. That means that there's a job over here somewhere, and they can go ahead and do it themselves before anyone else. On top of which, there may be some scumbag, douchebags, whatever, who will have a PDA, and they'll intentionally wait for other people if they know that other people are doing a certain quest, and they've already done it before, and they know exactly how the quest works. They can actually, what they can do is just go to the reward area, and they can just sit on it until other people, you know, finish it for them, and they can just hop over, grab all the rewards for themselves, and just get the fuck out, and you know, before anyone else can stop them. That if some other people do grab the rewards before they do, there are certain jobs that you can tell if someone's gone to the reward area before you have, and they're trying to steal your shit. Other jobs, there might not be such an obvious indicator. You'll understand what I mean by the time when I actually go into each of these quests in detail. But just for now, if you're on a PvP server, or if you're on a server where they don't care what happens to other people's shit, like, you know, if there's not a no stealing rule, then that means that there will be people out there who will just be like, hey, look, I can just let other people do the job for me, and I could just sit here and not do anything and just grab all the rewards for myself. Ha ha ha. Sucks for you guys, right? So just watch out for those kinds of guys, and If you do know the ins and outs of those of the jobs that you're trying to do, it's always wise to put like one guy watching over the reward area and make sure that no one else touches it. And if someone does, well, you know, go ahead and light them the fuck up. Let's see, what else do I need to mention? There are jobs that you can do by yourself. I'm not gonna try to overhype these top quests or whatever. There are jobs that you can definitely do by yourself. There's at least like a couple, two or three of them out there that you can definitely do by yourself. However, it's always much safer to roll with a group of people, like at least one other person, so that he can, you know, cover you. He can, if you die, he can, you know, pick you up, okay, grab your stuff, whatever, make sure that, you know, you're safe, whatever you need to do. You know, it's always much more effective. I mean, that's kind of how Origins is already set up, designed anyway, to make sure that people play with each other, make sure that they depend on one another for survival. But with the addition of these quests, it's even more emphasized, or it's even more heavily emphasized. So it's always imperative that you go with more than one person, especially if it's the first time you're going to do these quests. You have no idea what you're doing, or you have no idea what you're trying to get yourself into. If you already know how these quests work, and you know that for a fact you can actually do these jobs by yourself, then by all means, go ahead. If you die, then that's your own fault, and you knew what was in store for you. However, if you don't know what's going on, if you don't know how these quests actually work, especially if you're trying out a new job and you're trying to see, okay, what's going to happen, and I want to learn what I need to do in order to complete this job, you know, in the future more effectively, then it's always a good idea to, you know, hang around with, you know, a couple guys, a couple buddies, like, you know, a group of three, group of four. You always need at least one partner, in my opinion, but anywhere from 3 to 5 people in your group is very, very optimal. I believe that that's the best amount of people. Like, it's a very efficient amount of people for most quests. There are some other quests that you may want a little bit more, maybe like a group of 6, 7, perhaps, I don't know. But for the most part, you shouldn't really need more than 5 people for most quests. So keep that in mind. Other than that, that's basically it for these quests. Those are the general tidbits information that I can get, that I know about the quests that I can share with you guys. And these quests are very, very interesting. These quests are very, very rewarding, depending on what kind of job you do. I just think that they add a lot more dynamics. Plural, to the gameplay of the DayZ Origins. I'm very glad that they actually released this, because it gives you a lot more incentive to go out there and run around and hunt down people, whether it be AI or, you know, other players if you're on a PvP server. And it's just very fun overall. And it may be frustrating. Yes, I know. There will be some deaths that you'll be like, okay, that's just bullshit. But then again, these are AI. You know, we all know how AI work in DayZ Origins. They're either terribly coded, or they're the worst fucking AI you'll ever meet in, you know, any video game ever. But, if you know what you're doing, and if you play safe, play conservative, you will finish these quests, and you will reap the rewards from that. And just always remember, you know, DayZ Origins is all about conservative play, and these quests are no different. So play safe, play conservative, and make sure you play in a way that you know how everything's going on, or how everything happens, what's going on at every single time, and you should be fine, and you can get all the rewards you want. So thank you guys very much for watching. I actually don't know what I'm going to put for this gameplay, but whatever. Just go out there and have fun doing the quests, and I hope you guys get a lot of stuff from them. So, thank you guys very much for watching, and I hope you guys have enjoyed the tutorial video on the DayZ Origins 1.7.8.5 patch regarding the new PDA Electronica and the quests. So, yeah, we'll see you guys later. Bye. Back.
So, what the fuck?
Shit.
We're definitely in the right spot.
Yeah, there's no questioning that. There we go.
God just hates us.
Well, if you put
Jesus
it that way.
Jesus Christ, why have you forsaken us?
And my daily lament of Mountain Dews.
You must sacrifice unto him all the Mountain Dews that we can spare. The Ten Commandments of Jesus Christ.
Well, I like this gun. I like that it uses Stanag.
Found it.
What, really? Okay, everyone, don't trigger it. Everyone else,
it's already been triggered. In it.
It's triggered. Get in.
We're being ambushed. We're gonna be ambushed in a second. Get in.
Ambush. Retreat.
Who's not here?
Me.
I guess I'll be right gunner then. Yep. They said there's bandits headed our way now.
Cool. Now we get some action.
Make sure to check the lumber yard down there. And the forest. Goddamn, they'll definitely be in the forest.
Tags.
No tags either. Nothing. They probably spawned a little bit further away, and then they're just gonna come congregate onto our position. There's a citizen down there. Is that just a zombie?
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure that's just a zombie. Because AI would get hero dead. Oh, I see him out in the lumberyard. Got one.
Searching.
Wait, hold on. I'm pretty sure that was a dude. Why didn't I get the kill for it?
I think we're stable.
Right.
Do your kills with machine guns not register? They register for me last server restart. Why didn't
it's supposed to register?
Because I know he went down. He made the little death animation of going down. It's just my AI count didn't increase. Taking shots. I don't see the tracers anywhere. Not from the right side.
Can we got call one. That out?
Got one on the left side.
Alright.
Right along the road
that.
By
it's in the
trees.
Tree line behind us. Rear gunner would be right side. I see him running around. There's a lot of them over there. Hold on.
Oh, I see him. I'm not in range. Turn me around. Turn me around, real quick.
Should be good. Rear gunner should get shot too.
No, just
one by the road, next to the tree.
Oh, I got hit.
All right, get down and bandage up. You can get out and bandage if you need.
Coming your way, rear gunner.
Where was
right
this
along
guy?
The road. Right along the road. Third tree from the forest.
We're still taking fire somewhere else.
Did he go prone or did he was
behind
he killed?
Us, behind us, a lot of fire back behind us, dude.
There's a lot of fire back there.
Oh, jeez.
I had a tag for a split second.
Him,
I see him. Can you. Fuck.
Can we call that out?
I can't snipe this because I'm bouncing all over the place. 300 meters.
Oh, over there in the tree line, I see him. Get the yep. rear gun and kick his ass.
Should I go into rear gunner then?
No.
Already a minute.
Alright.
He's still running back and forth in that same spot. He's going left, or right to left right now. Kind of behind the orange tree.
Should I try getting out and support him with sniper fire, or too risky?
Yeah.
Alright.
Go over his right.
293 in the pine trees.
Oh, I see him.
Can you shoot through this, this thing? I don't really know. Yeah.
Maybe.
I'm not gonna try it.
Just don't shoot him.
Yeah.
I think you might have got him.
I got two kills now.
You had those two kills before.
There should be people left on the left gun.
Oh shit, I'm hit. Aw, there you got me with the VSS.
Whoa, VSS.
Yeah.
300.
All that shit will just break it the rest of the way.
Alright. We should go out in style and kamikaze the flying fortress into the rest of the bandits.
This sounds like a great plan.
Yep, very good plan. Okay.
I've buried this thing more than once, don't challenge.
Rear gunner. Alright, I'm gonna be shooting out the asshole with this one. Feels great.
Only if there were crafts any Hueys, we could go Viet. Boy, the Hueys have rocket launchers on them?
Maybe certain kinds of Hueys, but I don't think the standard one.
The in-game ones, though.
No, they don't have rockets, dude. They don't have M240s.
Okay.
There are no rockets in DayZ Origins. Just letting you know. It'd be kind of cool if there were.
Yeah, I was gonna say we could go Vietnam style on freaking Sector B.
Hey man, if they put in the Little Bird variant where it has the miniguns or the anti-personnel or anti-material missiles on them, get a fleet of just get a squadron of those and bam. You gonna fuck your shit up.
I thought I saw one running across the green field when we...
Yeah, looks like there's a gray thing beneath us, but I think it's dead.
Like, well, that's my body.
You mean my body?
Well, yeah.
One was in the tree line.
Hold on, I see something in the fields, but I'm not too sure. Hold on, I'm taking shots at this thing. Oh no, he was still alive! He was still alive, that dude's dead.
Okay.
Alright, there's another one to the front, now going to the right.
Where is he, in the field?
Down. Should almost be right below us. Couldn't tell what it was, but it was something. Be kind of front,
I see him.
To the front of us, but right.
Oh, he's done.
Yeah, that's getting a flash.
The mission.
Alright, did the mission update?
101, 148.
Alright.
It won't register those kills, will it?
No, it will register them. It registers for me.
Do we have to land and get bodies?
Yeah, but just my body, though. I'm thinking
just in the tree line to the left side.
Okay. To the left side. Okay.
I'll get out and help you look.
Alright. Oh, whoops. Get out. Right.
Yeah, this should have been,
Yeah, it seems like it would have been around here somewhere.
We need two coordinates, huh?
Drop my shit.
It automatically is gone.
Nah, my... body, unless it got imploded right when it hit the ground.
I'm talking about the mission.
Oh, okay.
It's right north of Gorka.
Saw me running up.
Ow! Holy shit. Goddamn zombie.
I'm looking for my body.
It was in the tree line. I know it was like.
In the forest over
in the forest.
Okay,
yeah.
Where Juice is.
Over there, or maybe the other side. I'm not sure which. Help you look. I just started getting blooded. Is someone after the box yet?
I think we already got to that box the first time, so now we just got to go to the coordinates.
There was nothing inside the box anyway, that's usually how it goes.
I don't see nothing up here. thought it was kind of down by the flat area.
Yeah, I thought it was. I don't think my body fell out in the forest necessarily.
Mission over, or we?
No, we still have a few parts left to it though.
Just not gonna take much, but we need to recover Oku's body.
Yeah.
Okay, this is one of the bandit dudes, so that's not it, obviously.
Here it is, got it.
Oh shit, I'm dropping frames.
Here, I'll shoot in the direction if you don't. Do you know where I am?
Yeah, I got your tag. Alright, I see it.
Right behind a tree.
Of course.
Firing.
Zombie?
Yeah. Just a random flashlight. Oh, that's yours, too.
Oh, damn.
What the fuck?
How do we down there? Run, little man. You're a soldier. You can run. Alrighty. Got it.
Good to go.
Nope.
Pick up my stuff.
Picking up those goods.
Okay.
Got it. Be heading over.
Wait, how do I add PKT rounds to this?
Have PKM mags in your main inventory, and then scroll wheel while you're inside the turret, and then you should be getting an option that allows you to add mags directly into your machine gun turret.
Well, it'll only fill it so full.
Yeah, for the Flying Fortress, you can put up to 5 reserve mags, not including the one that's currently inside your turret. Yep, we're good. I'm inside. I like how the PDA says, "Wow, you survived?"
That's stick out on the island.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, I don't know if I can land there. We'll see.
Looks like there's a...
Can I go under the bridge?
I don't know. Can you?
Yeah, but I don't want to. But I'm gonna.
Whee! And a bridge goes right over us. I shall volunteer to be the shock trooper. Or the paratrooper, whatever.
Yeah, this thing doesn't let you do that. You just die.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
If you still want to, go for it, man.
I'll be like, I'll eject, eject, eject.
What if you hover, like, just above the ocean and then boom the rest of it?
The one time I saw that happen, it broke their legs when they hit the ocean.
No, but just like a little bit over that. I don't know. Was that a sub?
I think that
is one of the sub spawns is at the south end of this base or island.
That should be a natural spawn.
That's where I originally got my first one.
Oh, it's on this. I always read the goddamn map backwards.
Someone's gonna have to run down that road a little ways.
I can do it. I don't mind running. No. Ready?
I suppose we all should. I
think in case there's something there.
Yep.
Pull it up.
I think it completes it.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's one. Probably one of those jobs where it just tells you to go somewhere, you get ambushed, and you go to somewhere else, and then boom, yeah. There you go.
We're supposed to take the stash to these other guys. Is the deal. So.
Try look for survivor AI, like unarmed dudes.
Yeah.
I totally lost humanity for shooting him in the head, Evan. Don't feel bad, I mean, I really didn't mean to kill you, but yeah, I lost humanity.
I lost a lot.
Who's the level?
There they are, just standing in the road, do you see?
Yeah, I see them.
Standing in the road?
No, they're standing in the road.
Just standing there.
Probably be like, loot the shit from the box behind us.
Yeah, that's probably what they'll do. Yep. There you go. Take your share in the box behind us. Someone take care of the zombies, please.
There's a zombie.
Box behind us. Where is this box? Someone's getting pummeled.
Oh. I don't have silenced weapons. So
I'll take him. I'll take him. Don't worry, I got him.
What's in here?
I don't know. I can't get into it.
Check out the barracks.
Camo, couple PKM.
Ooh, hold on, don't touch him.
Fair bag.
Five Sten eggs, NVG,
fair bag.
Two PKMs, a G36A.
And an NV goggles. Those NV goggles will be useful. And then bear bag. I'll take the PK. Oh, never mind.
I'm throwing it all in the fucking.
What is this bear bag?
It looks like a bear when you put it on your back, if you can see
the bear. That's pretty cool.
Funny.
Alright, well, we're good to go here.
Alright.
There was an AUG in there?
I'm gonna go throw this shit in
the. It's 368.
I checked the other three, there's nothing in it.
Hey, it's nice that these jobs give you MVGs, though.
Yeah, that's pretty cool because it used to be fucking insane.
Rare as shit. I mean, yeah. We can all depend on Jesus Christ to give us extra pairs of MVGs, but This is really nice now. I mean, all things considered, these jobs aren't really that hard. Just a little bit of traveling, just shooting people a couple times, and boom, you've got MVGs.
They're hard if you're by yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But if you got a group, and you guys have the patience to do these over a couple restarts, then everyone's got MVGs.
And I don't mind dying that often.
Me neither. I have a humanity sink of over 117,000 humanity, so I can die a couple times.
Single good run of the Sector B will get you all MVGs.
Rear gunner.
Did anybody pick up those stand eggs in the
Yeah, I think someone going did. In the Flying Fortress right now.
Wait, you wanted right?
No, I just picked it up because you guys were like, well, what are we going to do? And I was like, well, we're just going to throw it and someone can deal with it later.
No, I'm saying, who wants the right gunner?
Oh, the right gunner?
Okay. I just jumped in it because someone jumped in the left one.
Alright. I got their rear. We can go do the bandits camp thing again. Fly around until we find it.
I don't think I have that in me.
Yeah, I'm starting to fade myself.
Alright.
Me too.
Went back to work all this last week.
Mm-hmm. Well, used to get up at 4:30.
I think Evan's the farthest. drop Evan off.
That pain, all right.